Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. If you're into learning DaVinci Resolve filmmaking tips and tricks, having a look at some cool gear and things of that nature, this channel is for you, and I would recommend you to subscribe for the channel. So not that long ago, I did this tutorial, as you see right here, where I showed you how to do this UFO shot. And the way I did that was I was using a photo and I was using a shape which were just animated during the movement, or animated to follow the movement. But I have now found out a better or a way faster technique than that. So that's why in this video we're going to have a look at how to animate a UFO into your shot. So without further ado, let's get right to the video. Okay, so let's have a look at this clip shot on the Blackmagic Pocket Cinema Camera 4K. And as you might see out of this handheld shot, it does need a little bit of stabilization. So I'm going to choose the stabilization and I am going to click on the camera lock and I'm just going to push stabilization or stabilize. And then I have done that and that is all great and dandy, and this is exactly what I do want. But there's a little bit of something wrong. Because if I do a stabilization in the Edit tab and go into Fusion, and now it's, of course, rendering in the back because it's in Fusion, and the stabilization does not come with from the Edit page, so it's not stabilized at all. And that sucks because that is absolutely what I wanted. So you could see it right here. So I have kind of a hack or way to fix this. So let's go back to the editing page. And as you see, this looks much better. So if I right click and I just do a new compound clip here. And let's call this, I don't know, let's say plate. And I'm just going to create that. And here we are, nice, just the way I want it. So let's go back to Fusion. And of course, it yet again needs to think about what it's doing. So I'm just going to rearrange the space a little bit. And then if you see on the clip now, it is just the way that I wanted it. So just a little hack on how to fix that. Okay, so let's get right to the tutorial part of this. So first, I'm going to drag in my UFO photo. I'm going to have that around here. And I'm going to push that on screen number 2, just for now. And I'm going to rename this. And I'm on the DaVinci Resolve editor keyboard, and I have to use the FN, or the function button, and F2. To do the rename. If you are on a normal PC keyboard, you can just push F2 and, of course, rename your clip. In this case, plate and UFO. So let's continue again. So I'm going to drag down a polygon tool and I'm just going to push that on my viewer 1. And actually, I don't have that much space to work with, so let's enable one of the window. I'm just going to use window 2 here, and I'm just going to draw a shape around the UFO, as you see right here. And for the first round of this thing, it doesn't have to be too perfect. So I'm just going to do this pretty fast, and then I'll correct my mistakes right after I've done the first part of the masking here. So there we go. Nice and dandy, and of course there is some mistakes and I'll just have to correct those pretty fast here. So I'm just going to adjust my mask a bit here and make this a little bit better. Also want to do something of the corrections here, like so, and well, good enough. I'm going to connect the polygon to the photo, and this is what we have, a UFO. And now I'm just going to go into the inspector, and I'm going to
You could use the soft edges. In this case, I don't want that to be soft at all because my masking is so bad. Instead, I'm going to use the border width. I'm going to make that a little smaller, so more or less my bad masking would be covered. And then I'm just going to drag down a merge node, and I'm going to connect my UFO. And then in the media out, I'm going to push 2 or drag it up to get it into my composition here. Okay, and I'm going to make some more space to work with, but then again, this is a little too much. So something like this here, I think would be good. So first off, let's start by making the thing move, right? So I'm going to the merge node. And then I'm just going to go to the beginning of the timeline. And in the merge node, I'm going to think about how I want my UFO to be. I want it to be coming from behind here, and I'm going to mess around with the angle as well. And then I am going to make it a lot smaller. So let's say we want our UFO to kind of come flying from behind this roof up here, and I'm just going to hit the keyframes for the movement or the center and the sizing and the angle as well. And then I'm just going to go to the end of my composition here. Either I can, of course, I'm going to make it bigger, but I'm also going to just drag it to another position. And I'm also going to mess around with the angle so it'll have a little bit of movement. And let's say we wanted to, I don't know, let's say we wanted to pass here, something like that. So here we have our UFO flying by. And obviously we have a couple of issues, but we're going to look into that a bit later. So another thing we could actually do is we could go up here in this last thing here and enable motion blur just to make it a little more alive. And that's easily done like this. And we could, of course, change that, but I'll just leave the settings as it is in the default because that's okay. So now we're coming to the next part of our thing. And actually, this is what this video more or less is about. It's the portion where we want to add in a shadow into this thing. So I'm just going to push Control Spacebar and type shadow, and I'm just going to add that into my composition, and I'm going to push Shift and drag that into our composition. And if you look at it now, you don't see anything, but if we go into the inspector of the shadow, as soon as we start with the shadow offset, you can see we have a shadow of our UFO. And we can just move that wherever we want. And now we actually have the shadow or the shape of the UFO. And we can then replace that or put that wherever we want it to be in our scene here. And also I'm going to go over here and I'm going to make the shadow a little more transparent. And also I'm going to make it a lot more soft, as you see here. So there we have that thing, which is pretty awesome. So I'm also going to put in some keyframes at the shadow. And also we have more settings down here where you can play around with the light position, but we're not going to use time on that. But now you know it's there, and there's a lot of other things we could do. Okay. So let's see, we can now animate our shadow as you see now. I'm just moving it where I actually want it to be. Like maybe I want it here, and maybe I want it to cover something, or, well, that's only your imagination who is going to decide that, I guess. So now I have a shadow which is animating and it's following the UFO. And of course, as you have seen already, we have some issues because I think the UFO should come from behind the house here. And I'm going to do that by Control C, Control V, or just duplicating my plate, which I have here. And then I am just going to put in another merge node. And I'm going to take in a polygon. And I'm going to take the plate, the duplicate of the plate, and push 2. So now I have only the plate. I'm going to put that to the beginning of the clip. And then I'm just going to draw a shape of what I want to move. So I want to take part of this house here. And I want to, let's zoom in a bit here. Don't care too much about the flowers. This part of the roof, I want to be in the front or the foreground, and also the roof here. I want that to be in the foreground as well. So I'm just going to quickly mask that out, like so. And then I'm going to connect that to the polygon, to the plate 1. And then I am going to make a little more room because I need to do a thing more. And of course, I am going to, again, since I did copy paste the plate once, I'm going to do it one more time. So, and we're going to go in and I'm going to put in another merge. I'm going to take my plate 2 after I put in a polygon. And what I want to do with my second mask thing here is I want to mask out part of this lamp here. Again, for the sake of this tutorial, I'm not going to use too much time on this. If it looks crappy, it's okay. It's totally on purpose because this is just to show you the basic idea anyways. So I'm just going to make yet again another shape. Like so, and then I have now done that. And now I'm going to connect that polygon into my plate copy number 2. I'm going to put my plate copy 2 in my merge 3 as a foreground. I'm going to do the same as with my copy of the plate. Again, and now we have this thing here. So, pretty neat, I think. And a pretty nice way with the shadow. So this is just one way of doing this. And of course, we can do a little bit more because we are doing it this anyway. So I'll give this a bit of color. I have a just a small idea of what I want to do. So let's just do something super simple with this. I'm just going to play around with the contrast of it. Something like that. Give it a bit of saturation. And then let's go to the second tab, and then in the temperature, I'm just going to make that to 100. Give it a bit of color boost. And then I am actually going to take some of the saturation out because I have a little idea. And let's go back to the editing page. Let's go up to our media pool, and I have this VHS effect thing I made a while back, and it's super fun to do. So I'm going to take a part of that out, dragging that onto our clip, and then I'm just going to the inspector, and I'm going to change the composite mode to screen, so we'll have these VHS lines, and that's kind of fun. A fun little look. I'm going to do, again, with the VHS layer selected, I'll just go into the color tab again, and I'm just going to boost the contrast and also the saturation, and I'm going to go to the temperature, making it a little more yellowish, playing around with the tint, and then boosting up the color boost, and now I have this thing, and well, I think that is pretty darn fun. Anyway, I do hope you found this video useful. If you did, please hit that subscribe button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it will help them out, and if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on the channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.